here we've got a brand new Chargeverter Plus, which is obviously different from the Chargeverter GC that we're used to, and then the OG green or yellow Chargeverter.
Yeah.
So what's the difference between this one and what we're used to seeing?
Yeah, so you can, I don't know how well you could tell on camera, this is a little bulkier. We designed it with a IP54 enclosure. Of course, it had to be a little bulkier to make up for the, you know, heating and all that stuff to keep it as efficient as possible. We don't want it to overheat, so it's a little bulkier. But we wanted to make it a little bit easier to install in a multitude of locations. So this would be a lot more available for things like, you know, if you were going to put it closer to the generator, maybe under awning, stuff like that. You don't want it to be in direct rain with an IP54 rating, right?
It's basically dust and...
Dust and splash proof.
Splash.
Yeah, so it's a bit more protected against things like that, just to kind of help. We did pursue, I believe it's UL 1012, because there were a lot of folks who needed to have it written into their plan sets if they were installing all of it together. And so we wanted to make sure that this could get through some of the tighter jurisdictions. And, you know, kind of the peace of mind of just having a UL listing on things can help, you know, settle some ease.
As far as features are concerned, aside from the UL listing and the size of the breaker cover there and the slight advantage in dust protection and whatnot.
Yeah, yeah.
Is there anything else that it does that the GC does not?
Yeah, absolutely. So we actually spent a lot more time in the firmware, trying to make sure that at launch it would have more features, quality of life in particular. So we went through and we, you know, of course, generator cool down and warm up was a big thing. We want to make sure that when you have generators using this, especially in automatic situations, that it preserves the life of those generators as best as possible. There's also a global shutdown timer that you can set if you would like to have a 20-minute, 30-minute to kind of manage your fuel economy on your generator. Because, you know, a 5 kilowatt-hour charger, if you have a lot of batteries, it could take a long time for this to fully charge up your batteries, and you don't want to use so much fuel, maybe you can set that global timer. And then there's a couple of other small things, you know, upgrading the LCD screen to just show more information about, you know, the lifespan of the Chargeverter Plus. So it'll show you, of course, kilowatt-hour throughput over the lifespan, a couple of other bits and bobs of information about, you know, just using the thing.
Okay. Very cool. What's the price point going to be on this compared to the GC?
I don't actually know off the top of my head right now. I don't know if that's been released, but maybe we could get that information from one of our sales guys if they've already figured that out, but I don't actually know. Sorry.
Okay. Do we actually have a release date on...
Off the top of my head, I don't know if we have a release date for this, but I believe it will be before the end of 2025. So this should hit the market before the end of 2025. Okay. But I can't remember if we have it set to be around the time of Black Friday or not.
Okay. So. And then will it replace or just be in addition to the GC?
At first, it will definitely be just in addition to. We'll continue to carry both. If we see that this kind of takes over the GC, we don't have a whole lot of folks who really are interested in the GC anymore with the release of this, you know, we might pivot and make some adjustments to the GC or, you know, but for now, it's not in our plans to just terminate the GC.
I guess it depends on what the price point is, right?
Yeah.
Because if it's $50 more, or, you know, if it's, the cost is the same, then no one's going to be buying the GC, but if it's set as that premium plus version, I would hate to see the GC go away because people are already... get frustrated at the price increase over the old ones and the tariff prices and all that stuff. So it'd be good to see it stay feasible.
Yeah, for sure. We want to make sure that, you know, this style of accessory is available and as affordable as possible. So, you know, if the enhancements and features that get added to this thing, you know, aren't being well utilized, we want to make sure that there's still an option. That
now, I also note that. Like, I haven't seen the old 1,000-watt EG4 charger in years. Is there ever going to be another 1,000-watt charger? Is that just something nobody ever needed?
There might be. So once we kind of pivoted away from, I mean, well, so EG4 used to be batteries only for a long time. You know, when I first started with the company, we didn't actually have any inverters.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and then we released our 3000 EHV, which it was only 3.5 years ago, but it still feels like feels like a long time. But once we started getting into, you know, higher class inverters and bigger batteries, we saw that the, you know, the small power chargers just weren't going to be as effective for folks trying to charge up, you know, a 14 kilowatt hour battery.
Just it takes
didn't
a long
make as
time.
Much sense.
Yeah.
Now, that being said, we still service and provide our server rack batteries, which are 5 kilowatt hours each. We may create some more options on the charger output for things like the Chargeverter, but really, most cases that someone would need a charger, it makes more sense to have something like a Chargeverter GC or Plus.
Sure. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. While we're standing here, I'm curious, this is a new front panel and breaker here. So, at least based on what I have at my house.
Yeah.
So, is there anything that's different in here other than just, I guess this is a...
So,
yeah, that's different.
Yeah, I'm not sure from which version that you may have installed in your house, but this one, we went through a couple updates. There's, of course, this on the front just to make it more stylistically in line with our 12,000 XP, but we also updated the PV terminals on the 6,000 XP to be quick connects as opposed to requiring the old, I don't know what you call those type, but where you need that little screwdriver.
Right.
So we put in quick connects to make it that much easier for people to install the PV lines on the PVTs.
For sure. Very cool.